This is dedication right here. Up at 4 o'clock in the morning, driving at 5, starting the hike at 6. Sun's just starting to show itself. 3 mile hike in God's country to get it done. This is a nice young buck that would have been really sentimental to get because my dad shot one when I was a senior in high school in this exact location, but we knew there was a bigger deer there. Here he is. We got him on trail camera. He's an absolute stud. Wish we could have turned him up. He'll be bigger next year. The things I do for hunting. Right across the river to get to where I want to go. My wife bought this really nice truck to pull her pretty pink boat, but I'm glad it takes me where I need to go in the mountains as well. Thanks, honey. That would have come in handy. Then my toes wouldn't be frozen right now. This country's beautiful. That stuff is so hard to hike in. All those logs that got burnt, tipped over. Then you have the fire quakies in there that are about 5 to 10 feet tall. Choking each other out, but making it just impossible to get over all that deadfall. And through all those quakies that just grab a hold of you. Where's your dad at? Where's your dad at? Come here. Yes, this is the road right here. Hey, get out of the road. Get out of here. We found this buck at first light. He fed over the hill and ended up bedding right on the skyline. We watched him for about 45 minutes. I had the gun in position, ready to take him if he gave me an ethical shot. He got up out of his bed, took one look at us, and eventually fed over the hill in the wrong direction.
Falling again.
After hiking 8.9 miles that day, I get back to the truck to find this. I've been putting in for the big bull hunt for the last 19 years and finally drew it for the 2020 late season on the Manti. Called my dad to let him know, and we got super lucky. He also drew out, but only with 7 points. Not wanting to have two golden tickets in our pockets, I turned mine in and have a good chance of drawing next year, and we'll hunt his in a couple of weeks. These two bulls were getting after it, so I thought I'd film. What are you doing? Blew a tire. Thankfully, we're just about 5 or 6 miles from Huntington.
Check this out. I know it's hard to believe.
Getting her done.
I'll tell you what, Chandler just grabbed these tools right out of my hands. Got a flat tire here. I think he'd be real good on a record truck.
Got another job coming.
Had a flat tire come home from there, and this is what it's all about.
Gotta make it happen. This is where the big boys hang out. We've been hunting this area since I was, I think, 12 or 13 years old. Seen a few mountain lions, several big bucks and bulls. Man, the country's rugged. Lots of memories. Wouldn't be the same if we didn't come and check this area out every year. Without fail, we always see spikes on the deer hunt and really nice deer on the spike hunt. I'm sure you all can relate. Seems like every hunter has the same experience.
Okay, that's where the elk, the deer was taken. Our route out of here is right along here. Right along here. And then here. And that's where we gotta go, and it's ugly for an old man. but I'll make it. Hey, I got the whole experience, Chan.
You filming it?
Yeah. Phew. Okay, the surgeon's next.
Man, talk about good friends, good company. Got him.
How's that buck, Chan?
Awesome. Heavy. So awesome, though. Got both hind quarters, tenderloins, back straps, front legs, all loaded in the pack.
Brisket.
Got some good brisket. Worn out.